story of the windbag and the beginning. How we got here is on the breath of the will to live, the life force. A wind that blows through us. In the end was the beginning. Why does it start that way? Well, because it does. In the end, which as I said was really the beginning, there was a sharp wind coming from the south. Sharp wind had a smell of cinnamon because it had just meandered through a cinnamon tree forest, blowing and causing a ruckus just because it was so fun to see all the trees flailing their branches around like they were dancing to catch the leaves. Anyways, sharp wind was looking to get into something. You know that restless feeling that humans have that gets them into so much trouble? Well, they aren't the only ones who have this quality. The wind has it, too. Sharp wind was following a many-eyed cloud with thunderbolts when it spied something from way up high that it didn't recognize. What could that be, wondered sharp wind. A-kee-kee-kee-kee-kee-kee, it called. The mystery thing did not respond. A-kee-kee-kee-kee-kee, the wind reiterated. The mystery thing puffed gently, a sigh. A little smoke came from its top. The sharp wind blew closer to investigate, blowing through the leaves of a chestnut tree and hardly paying any attention to the cat hiding in the ferns at the bottom, watching all that was going on. Now this cat was a big cat, more like a lion, really. It had this way of watching things with its big, sleepy eyes, casually swinging its paw from side to side, just like this, just like that. He was smiling a knowing kind of smile, the kind of smile that suggests sort of confidence about the being that is smiling, slightly secretive but never coy. Now the reason that the cat was smiling was because it knew that the mystery thing, although calm and sedate at this very moment, was capable of creating a bust-up-shut hullabaloo with a capital B. Purred the cat. Things are looking up. Perhaps there will be a show. Let me tell you a bit more about mystery things. It looked like a big, craggy mountain that tapered off elegantly into two directions at its peaks on either side, kind of like ears. On sunny days, cloudy days, rainy days, if you squinted and looked at rocky, craggy mystery thing, there appeared to be two eyes. Sometimes they looked open, and sometimes they looked shut. Mystery thing was full of potential. In fact, mystery thing was potential. That was why the cat was smiling and swinging his paw from side to side to side to side. Perhaps it's time for us to give Mystery Thing a name. The cat called Mystery Thing the Seeing Volcano, and that, my friend, seems as apt a name as any. This is how it worked. Something would come along with a curiosity and wanderlust that was so big it could not, would not contain itself. Could not, would not, should not? Who am I to judge? This is how things happen. So the curiosity pants boundary pusher would wander closer to the Seeing Volcano. Perhaps it would smell something sweet and promising in the smoke puffings, or hear some barely audible and familiar melody, something that reminded it of its salad days or future promises or great Adidas limited edition shoe sales or whatever. It would creep closer and closer and closer and closer until it was actually inside the Seeing Volcano. Then wham, bam, thank you, man, an explosion would occur and something would happen. You see where it's going? Where's our wind? Oh, there you are, wind, and now you are tottering at the precipice of before. Sharp wind circled the left peak of Seeing Volcano. The pull was magnetic. Go in, go in, go in! Sharp wind took a deep breath, made itself as willowy as it could, and entered. Immediately there was great rumbling. The cat twitched its nose and swung its paw a little quicker than norm. And then all of a sudden there was a kaboom! And out flew wind, but this time not alone. Seeing Volcano's potential sharp wind windiness has created a tidal wave of life. It flowed from Seeing Volcano's peaks that looked like ears, filling the skies with strange beings, life forms, and ideas. Even cats lost its composure and ran for cover to avoid being squished and pummeled by giants and bouncing DNA balls. Two-headed strongmen, strange tents, clowns with no feet, as yet unnamed things,